Alright, we have a 2012 Mustang SVT Shelby. You can hear the rumble of this thing. You'll hear it even better when I get up to the back. Amazing sound. This is at Irwin's in Laconia. It's a white one. If you want racing stripes, you can add the stripes to it. You get a lot of people that don't want the stripes, so they order one without it. Then you have the option to add them. When you pay for them, the person's got to pay for them. Even if we take them off, and sometimes that they don't like that, so that's why they opted to try one without it. See how it goes. Nice. Really, really nice. Spend a little more time on the outside than I normally do, obviously, because it's a Shelby. Again, it's 2012 version. All right, let's check out that motor. Hood and the trunk. That's the push button on the trunk. Have the cover. I thought last year they had covers. Battery's easy to get to. Fluids, there's a fuse box, antifreeze, another antifreeze. Great. Oil fill right there. Man, that's a lot of motor. Special wheels, insignia from Shelby GT, says Shelby across the back. Here's your trunk. It appears those rear seats do drop down. Not sure that was available last year. Could have been, but probably never really cared to try to bring them down. Can't imagine me hauling too much in the back of one of these. Alright, I'm gonna put everything back down. Alright. Now the best part about it, Shelby, the sound. one more click of the outside. We'll do the inside. Not a whole lot to the back of one of these. Alright, so for the inside we got power seats. And it does have a latch to flip it forward. There's your rear compartment. Again, not really a whole lot to these. Now, not really gonna get into it. Almost looks like that seat comes forward.
Yeah, it must, because this one looks like it's already loose.
But you can drop the headrest down so that you can see better out the back.
Alright, bring the seat back.
Put it back in a comfortable position. Alright, so here's your, obviously, for your power windows, your power locks.
Okay.
Steering wheel goes up and down. It's as high as it goes right now, so I gotta bring the seat down some. Okay. So here we have inside compartments is your light controls. That's what turns on your floods. You can see they're on right there. Alright, here's your info and setup for mileage information, which is over here on the gauges. And you can see it yells right out, it's an SVT right there. Again, these are your gauges. Okay, so here we have the insignia again of the Shelby 500. And then you have your cruise control here. You have your radio controls here, which I need to make sure the volume is all the way down, which it is. And then you have your push to talk, so you can set your cell phone. Okay, now this one does have navigation, as you can see, as well as the climate
Sorry,
and everything else.
Please say a command or say.
Okay. Alright. You're not going to go off again on me, are you? Thank you. Alright, and there's your map. Obviously, you have the ability to control from here your radio, it's a shaker system. There's your volume, your tune. There's all your presets. Here's your climate control settings here. Here's your little sink garage. No, it's not a garage actually on this one. Traction control. Hazards. That was what I pushed to get the trunk to open. You have a little cup holder with the little light, the LED lighting. So it's very easy to find the cup when you're going down a road. Obviously, 6-speed shifting knob. Parking brake. All right. Overhead lights, lit mirror on the visors. It's kind of a cool look here. It's like a, I don't know what you call it, but it's got that brushed metal look, but it's got the dented, and I'll think of it. Get your glove box. Anyways, cool look to it. And this got like a little soft here leather. So you get your normal leather here, but this got like a little soft leather right here in the corners. All right, now this is a coupe, not a convertible. A little storage area here. And this is where your, if I get this out, you can see. Oh my goodness. Wow, that didn't come out easy. Here's all your sync controls. There's your plug-in, there's your USB, there's your power. I didn't put these over here in this glove box. That would have made more sense. There. Now this compartment's open like it should be. All right, and you have a... All right, so that's the interior. Nice look. From inside, see what you can hear for sound.
watts power.
Nice. That's what you're looking at out the dash. Alright, so this is fully loaded with a nav. I know we didn't do it. We didn't do the
window sticker. So we'll still try to get the sticker in on my walk around. So we'll do a quick of the vehicle.
Here we get a little sunshine. What shot do I want? That's cool. All right, real quickly, here you go. You see it's 55,000, it's 48 standard. You're getting the electronics navigation package, the SVT performance package, and that's what gets it up to the 55,000. It's about the same as last year because I purchased some of these last year for a buyer over in Australia. And you get 1523 overall, 17. And you can see it's the 2012 Shelby GT Coupe. And this, it's got the Brembo brakes, and I think the tires, wheels are a different wheel. It should be an upgraded wheel. No, I guess not. It would be noted over here. Nope. So this is a standard wheel, I guess. It doesn't say it's a special wheel. All right. So. Alright, my battery's getting low and I gotta get it charged so I can get that 2012 Lincoln shot. Got a 2012 Lincoln I'm trying to do next. So I'm gonna turn it off, get some nice pictures, and move on to the Lincoln. Now, supposedly they got a Laguna Seca and the Boss 302 coming, so they should have a good selection of Mustangs, though.